So, do you like my Walmart Pact? This is a thing that was made, I think, a couple of years ago at Google Next in San Francisco. And we've been using it as part of a kind of series of tutorials and learning resources. I say ostensibly the talk is about Google Cloud, but really it's about a specific piece of open source software called OpenCloud. To run that on Google Cloud. So I'm going to pause this and take you over here and introduce who I am, what I do, that kind of thing. So my name is Sharif Salah, a technical writer at Google Cloud based in London. So fairly local to you. I'm also open source contributor on OpenQ. The project's based on GitHub. We have the site and we have the project itself. I'll just point out that what I'm planning to do, because this is like the first talk I've given on OpenQ, I've done a couple of demos, and this is going to be more demo-y, to be honest, but I'm probably going to post links that I use in the talk on LinkedIn. So there's my LinkedIn link if you want to get access to the resources. And it's this technical writer, so that's my spend a lot of time writing, also teaching slides and things like that. So I didn't want to give a talk where I was going to show you a load of slides or even write a load of slides. To keep it fun for everybody, I actually fairly interactive. I'm probably going to ask some questions and kind of do show of hands and show you lots of stuff. So some sample code and some demos of the software, and then we'll do some Q&A. This was the end result. But if we scoot over to here, this was actually generated from a Blender. So how many people familiar with the Blender project? So good chunk of the audience, I'd say probably about half. So Blender is basically an animation rendering package. It's open source, like a are not affiliated. OpenQ actually supports a bunch of rendering engines, depending on how you kind of bake them into the scheduler. It's fairly arbitrary. As you'll see, actually OpenQ is very flexible in the use cases beyond rendering for video, film, or gaming. So this is the project, and artists on big budget films, they might have millions of hours of compute time to render, and they need something to manage that workload. So you've got hundreds of artists all submitting jobs concurrently to a big cluster. How do you manage that? Well, the big studio scheduler. At Google, we've offered for several years a product called Zinc, which is a managed scheduler, but that one is proprietary. So the one I'm talking about today, OpenQ, is open source. OpenQ is actually, it started off as a collaboration between Sony Pictures Imageworks and Google Cloud, but then it got donated and handed over to the Academy Software Foundation. So what's behind me is landscape.aswf.io, which you can check out, which gives you a kind of overview, high-level overview of what the Academy Software Foundation is sort of managing in terms of projects and related projects. So down into imaging and color, asset management and workflow, rendering and queuing, which is the category for OpenQ you'll see down there on the bottom left-hand side. And the font is fairly small there, math and simulation. So that's where OpenQ fits into the set of tools. And there's a lot there that is, I think, broadly applicable to lots of other domains. It's just that these are primarily aimed at, but there may be stuff on there that you might be very interested in, so do take some time to check that out after the talk. But we're going to focus on OpenQ and running OpenQ on Google Cloud. So what is OpenQ? Well, OpenQ, as projects go, the contrast is a little hard to see on that slide. This is in the documentation, by the way, so it'll be included in the link. But it's a fairly kind of in-depth project, I guess. There's lots of moving parts. So at the top, actually, let's start with the artist workstation. So I just showed you Blender running on in this case. So the artist is running their rendering package or their 3D modeling program, and they want to submit some work. So they submit work to OpenQ over the network using a program called Q that talks locally to a API layer called PyOutline, which in turn talks to another API layer called PyQ. The reason I'm just calling out PyOutline or Outline in general is that you don't have to use the use you. There are command line options, and there is an extensive API as well. So you could script submitting work to the cloud or to your rendering engine or to your cluster using it for something other than rendering. So after you submit, you want to be able to monitor your job. So that's where QGUI comes in, and that's a PySide 2 app. And so all of these talk to the brains of OpenQ, which QBot server up there. And then the QBot server does its, basically its accounting on the QBot database. So that's running there. That's a PostgreSQL server, typically. And then the QBot server, once it's got its jobs and it's lined them up and it's ready to dispatch them, it sends them to the rendering agents. And those rendering agents, I call them rendering agents, but they could be doing other types of work. Primarily, for the purposes of this talk, we're talking about rendering work. So those agents are running something called RQD. And as part of the talk, I'll also show you how you can customize RQD so you can decide what you want to run on your node in your cluster. So as you can see, this is fairly involved stuff. And if you wanted to start like trying out and testing this and kind of kicking the tires on it, it could take you, I would say for somebody who's like pretty new to this stuff, it could take you the better part of a day, which is a big investment just to see if it's useful to you. So recently we came up on OpenQ with the idea of coming up with a way to try really simply, really easily, and really quickly. We thought, wouldn't it be really cool if you could spin up OpenQ on a workstation? So no cloud, no big cluster, no server room full of machines, just you and OpenQ or your workstation, and just see whether it sort of makes sense to you, whether you like kind of the features it offers. So we created something called the sandbox environment. So most of what I'm going to show you in the sandbox environment, but the same principles apply. You can very easily turn one rendering node into many and scale it out. So this is a how many people here familiar with Compute Engine in Google Cloud? No, nobody's familiar with Compute Engine. Okay, so I will take it from that. That's good. It means I can take it from sort of basic principles. In Google Cloud is our part of, is the sort of foundational service of our infrastructure as a service offerings, essentially virtual machines in the cloud. Each that you create is equivalent to a server, if you like. And typically, they do not have a desktop. These are primarily meant for running, you know, computing jobs, machine learning, that kind of thing. But for the purposes of testing out OpenQ and running the demo, what I've done is I've installed a desktop environment on this Debian Linux instance. So I'm going to show you how or how I got to there. But before that, if you take for granted that this is a server running on Google Cloud, and I'm connected to it over Chrome Remote Desktop, this is the OpenQ graphical packages, but also the OpenQ sandbox is running on the same machine. So everything I need to try out OpenQ is running on my Compute Engine instance. So in, with this instance, I've done all the work. Depending on time, I might have a go at trying to show you how you go about setting up the sandbox from scratch. But assuming I've finished my rendering work and I'm ready to submit, I use. So this is QSubmit running on my workstation. And I've got a bunch of attributes here that I need to set. I need to tell OpenQ what the name of the job is. In this case, I've just made up a username, Roboto. If I'm working on a kind of film or TV-based project, I'd be setting the shot. You could set this to anything arbitrary. And then layer. So the way layers work is they're essentially analogous to sub-jobs. So you've got a job, and then you can have sub-jobs within that job. And you can have, if you want to get kind of more advanced and, flexible about it, you can set up dependencies. So you could have several jobs, and one doesn't start until the previous one finishes. So what I'm doing here is single layer. So it's essentially it's just a job doing one piece of work. And I've got this piece of code. So this is saying command to run. So the cool thing about this is I can run anything that my code supports. It doesn't have to be a rendering workload. I could type hello world here. I could run like just a shell script, or I could run some piece of Python, anything I want to run on a distributed system. So I'm going to go over here and see if I can find that piece of code. I just blew it up so that we can look at it properly. What's happening, what I'm about to submit, so this rendering node has Blender. It's not going to use audio. It's going to ignore any audio. There isn't actually any audio in the project. I'm telling it where the Blender file is. So here with Blender, the footage that I started the talk with, that was kind of like the high-res version. For the purposes of the talk, I'm just going to switch to the low-res version just so that we see some actual activity happening and it's kind of submit the job. I'm also telling it where I'm outputting the result of the rendering operation to, and I'm tagging on the end of the frame number there. So I'm going to render frames. And then the format. I need to tell it what format, so I want JPEGs for this, and again, the frame number. This is the frame number for the ingest, like which frame within the Blender file are you supposed to operate on. So switching back to OpenQ, I'm pretty much ready to submit. You can see I've run some, as I was kind of getting ready for the talk, I was running some previous jobs. So I was basically just incrementing the number, test 01, 02, 03. So now I'm on test 07. And also the other thing I'm going to mention is range that I'm rendering is 600 to 700. You think about most kind of video footage, you're talking about 25 frames per second or something. So I'm rendering about worth of footage, and we've picked some interesting footage. So this is kind of part of a subsection of the video that you saw at the start of the talk. So I'm just gonna go ahead and click submit, and it pops up submitted job, and it gives you an ID. And if I go over to QGUI, so this window is what the artist would use to monitor their work. And it won't appear in, you have to prompt it. But there you see the job has appeared. So that's the, from where we're looking at it, it's the fourth one down. And it says testing, Roboto test. Sorry, underscore test 07. And you can see it says in progress there. So I can double click on that. And then in the monitoring section below it, which we can refresh, we're seeing it's actually running rendering nodes, two layers at the same time concurrently. And we can click on those and see the log of the output. So that actually looks like quite well. Blender has quit. So Blender was running in a container. It spun up the container, did the work, and it quit. So actually, if we go back to the monitoring window and we say refresh, you'll see that's now succeeded. Quick go and see if we can capture one running as it's going. So if we go over to the file manager, we will have a look at the finished result. So this is the low-res version, remember. So this is just viewing in GIMP, which is the equivalent of Photoshop on Linux, for those of you that aren't familiar with it. So pretty straightforward, pretty easy to actually submit the work. Okay, so I'm just going to leave that running. No need to stop it having fun. So if I scoot over actually just before the other machine that I have, it wouldn't be a Google Cloud talk without showing you the Google Cloud console. So the Google Cloud console here, and you can see in my project, I've got a single project and I've got two compute engine instances. So the first one, OpenQ Demo, is the one that you've just been looking at. OpenQ Sandbox is, honestly, I just picked the name arbitrarily. They're both running the sandbox. The difference is that the demo one I've kind of fiddled with a little bit. It's some stuff that I'm working on to publish for the open source project, which I'll talk you through later on. But the sandbox one is pretty vanilla. All I've done is engine instance, and I'll talk you through that in a second, and you'll be able to take pictures and whatnot if you want to be able to kind of recreate that. And left it pretty much as is. So, see if I can find my script, basically. I call it a script. This is actually one command, if you can believe it. So this is using the Cloud SDK that are fairly familiar with Google Clouds. This is the command line tool for manipulating resources. So in this case, I'm using the Cloud SDK to create a compute engine instance. So I say instances create, and then the name of the instance. And then there's a bunch of attributes and properties about this machine. So I'm using an image, which is Debian 9 stretch in this case. I want to pull that image from the machine type. This is worth noting. OpenQ is, it needs some memory. You know, I think off the top of my head, it might be, and I completely off the top of my head, but it, well, let me say this. On Mac, by default, it won't run on using the default amount of memory that's allocated to Docker. So you do tend to have to add some memory to this. I've given it a boot disk, and then I've also placed it in Europe. And I'm also reading, so this is important, right at the bottom there you see it says minus minus. I'm reading some data from Google Cloud Storage, which is our blob store. So what I'm reading is the very last line. I'm saying in the metadata there that I want to use a startup script. So I've got a startup for this particular compute engine instance. Startup script in this case is just a shell script, which is telling it a bunch of stuff that it needs to install. So it's going beyond the default. So out of the box, remember I said you don't interface, you don't get a graphical desktop. So all I'm doing here is I'm actually installing a Chrome Remote Desktop client and I'm installing a bare bones graphical desktop. So that's all I've done. So put that into my terminal, I run it. And that creates my machine, and that machine looks something like this when I boot it up. I really haven't done very much with this machine. A few commands that I did issue. So I was inspecting the log to look, make sure that it installed everything that was in that startup script. And then I did some stuff around kind of permissions to make sure I could run Docker. I made a directory. A couple of directories, and I also set up Chrome Remote Desktop. The only other thing I've done, just in the interest of transparency, is I've set up a variable for the OpenQ database password, just so that I'm not typing it on a live stream. But it's a fairly ephemeral password, to be honest. It's just for the sandbox. After the demo, I'm going to be blowing this machine away, destroying it. So I want to rearrange my tabs a little bit here. What I want to do is bring this window so that it's fairly close to this window. And it looks like it's just decided to disconnect. I should say I'm running everything a hotspot. So it's a little sluggish. That's why why some of the connectivity looks like it's a little sluggish. The machine's just gone to sleep. So, okay, let's scoot over back to a web browser. And I want to quickly show you where it is I am here. So this is the OpenQ site. This is not the main Google Cloud site, cloud.google.com. This is our site, openq.io. And there's some cool stuff on here. If you want to learn more about the Academy Software Foundation, there's a nice intro clip. It's about a minute. Definitely worth looking at. Also, a lot of kind of overview material of what OpenQ is, who it's for, and some community resources. So, you know, join the discussion forum or stay up to date by subscribing to the blog and so on. To the documentation. And I mentioned that we've got this sandbox environment. So the purpose of the sandbox environment is so that you can quickly get started. So we're looking at the quick starts. I'm running OpenQ on Linux, because that was the operating system that I had. My compute engine instance. But there is also a macOS version, for those of you that want to try it on directly on your laptop. And you need a few things to get started. And that's part of what I've been doing startup scripts. So, you need Python installed and configured. You need the pip command. You need virtualenv. You need Docker and Docker Compose. How many people in the audience familiar with Docker? Show of hands. So most people. Docker Compose? OK, so much less. I'll be honest, I didn't know anything about it. I didn't even know Docker Compose was a thing up until about like 3 months ago when my some of the other engineers working on the open source project mentioned it. Really cool. It turns out it is really cool. So I'll show you how you use Docker Compose to open up get the sandbox installed. And it's kind of a cool, neat thing anyway to learn about. So I need to grab a copy of OpenQ to run the sandbox. So I'm just going to copy this. And I'm going to paste it into a terminal. Home window, home directory. And then I've done most of these steps. So I'm just going to grab this one. I'm going to open that and let's set an environment variable. And this is telling OpenQ where the logging directory is for OpenQ. And then the password I've done before the talk. And then the final one is this Docker Compose command. So let's start this. And then while it's going, we'll head over and I'll show you what the Docker Compose file looks like. So I'm just going to go ahead. So now it's pulling a load of data onto my server from the cloud. OK, so let's go and see if I can find some cool code for the Compose component of OpenQ. So this is the Docker Compose YAML file for OpenQ. And it's basically declaring a load of services. And essentially, these are the services that are going to make up OpenQ. And each of those is a container. So you've got essentially a collection of containers that are running on your machine, and they make up OpenQ. This is describing the infrastructure components. This is not describing the components, the graphical components that you saw earlier on. So this is not like the stuff that would run on the artist's workstation. That doesn't really need to run in. So we've got the database. We've got Flyway, which is basically configuring the database and bringing all of the data in to run the demo. Qbot, remember, is the brains of OpenQ. QD at the bottom there, this section, that is the rendering node. And by default, the sandbox environment ships with the default vanilla image QD for OpenQ. So you can see that's actually what that's doing there, the image, OpenQ slash RQD, that's pulling from Docker Hub. So if you've used Docker before, that's just you can actually download those components from Docker. You don't need such an environment, but we also need some client packages that are going to talk to the server component so that we can render the robots. So I'm going to go back to another terminal, and I'm just going to go into, it's a little sluggish, going to the OpenQue directory and start a Python virtual env. This is essentially just a kind of Python sandbox. Here to run everything within a kind of virtual environment with Python. It works really neatly, basically. At the end of this, if this was my workstation, I could just blow the directory away, I could delete it, and I've gotten rid of all of that, those packages. So I'm just going to activate that environment. And I'm going to tell it what version of OpenQue I'm running. So for this, I'm going to go over here because we've got a slightly newer release that we released about a week and a half ago, I think. So that's my version of OpenQue. And I'm going to go ahead and run. We have, as part of the sandbox, we have an installation script that just goes off and installs all the packages. Again, no kind of icky steps to wade through. This is all very quick. The idea behind the quick start is you could try this later today or tomorrow, 15, 20 minutes max. And I'd love to hear if you find it takes you longer than that, because it means we need to trim more stuff off. Okay, so it's basically going to carry on that. There'll be a couple of steps that we need to just configure the client with. I'll talk you through those while we're just waiting for the installation script to finish. So the first one is we need to point it at a file. And then the other one is that we need to tell it where QBot lives. So we need to tell the client, the machine, the workstation that you're running on, where the QBot server is running, which is localhost. And then we can run. So if I skip back to the installation screen, you'll notice that's finished. So copy this and run these. I've already explained what they're doing and in the quick start fairly clearly. And so now the moment of truth is I'm going to run this command. Let's make this window a little bit bigger just so that you can read the output. So we have a positive response. So what's going on here is I'm running a tool called qadmin. Qadmin is the command line variant of the graphical applications managing an OpenQue deployment. And I'm saying list the hosts. So it can see a single host in the cluster. And the operating system is Linux, because remember, this is running inside a Docker container. So it's reporting that operating system state. It's saying it's ready, essentially, to run. And at this point, I can also crossed here that the demo-wise, everything works out. So it's installed qsubmit, and that's spinning up. And I can run. Whoops, fat fingering that, and QGUI. So pretty much what you saw on the other machine. And again, those took like 5-10 minutes to run. Cool, so the last thing I want to cover quickly is, this is great. This is pretty much where we leave you with the quick start. But you can't actually do anything very much that's interesting. The RQD nodes, the rendering nodes in your cluster, at the minute, they basically just include the default Linux tools that come as part of a Linux container. So I'm going to skip over here and talk you through something else that I've been playing around with, which is, remember, I was showing the Docker Compose YAML file. So before I get to, so I've got an updated version of the Docker Compose YAML file, and I've got an updated, so I just basically want to cover those two things to finish off. So most of this has been left as is. There's not too much that has changed. We've got the database, we've got the fly, stuff to make sure the database is working as expected. Qbot, I've left as is. What I have done is I've changed some of this code down here for RQD, so that's lines 46 through 60. Couple of things. One is that under volumes there, you can see I've set up a mount point, and the mount point is basically telling it where it's going to find the Blender file and where it should output the output renders to. Then under build, originally this actually said image. As you can see on Qbot line 32, it said image and then the container name, the hub. Instead, what I'm doing is I'm building my own custom Docker image, which I'm adapting, I'm building on top of that OpenQRQD bot. So it says build, and then the context, just where we are on the, and then the Docker file, and then I'm pointing at where the Docker file is on my file system. So this is what the Docker file looks like. It says from OpenQRQD, that's what we had before, that was the and then we've got a bunch of packages that I'm installing. So I'm doing yum update, and then install a bunch of dependencies. So these dependencies are dependencies that Blender 2.79 to run. And then I create a directory to run that in, download it, unzip it, untar it, and then get rid of it. And that's pretty much all there is. So standard, nothing particularly fancy. You can customize your own RQD instance using essentially this technique. Again, I haven't got around to documenting this, so you're seeing this before I've managed to actually document this for the project, which I hope is and interested again in feedback if people have feedback about like this workflow. So we can customize our RQD image. And the cool thing is this doesn't have to be a rendering agent. It could be any you want to do. It could be some sort of, for example, I'm into photography, and it occurred to me recently that I could use this to stitch huge panoramas, like I could do a kind of gigapixel panorama. Just something I've actually got around to, but in theory, if you can find the right open source packages, you can pretty much do that. A couple of other things just to finish off. That's kind of pretty much it for the demo. I'm going to a couple of like pictures and resources that might be useful to you. So on OpenQ, we've just published this. This is the most recent document that we've on the OpenQ site, and it's our first case study. So this is a case study of how Sony Pictures Imageworks runs the pre-open source release version of OpenQ internally. Diagram just to illustrate how this works. One thing that's really cool about this diagram is you can see the render farm there, and from the text, if you go through and read it, they're actually using for their render, actually installing RQD on their workstations, and that makes total sense. So you can actually use you could use OpenQ to manage workloads within a workstation group. It doesn't necessarily have to be a running in a data center or in the cloud. Another resource I'll quickly call out to before we go to Q&A is we have a more in-depth article which we published kind of towards the beginning of the year. And this is a much more in-depth version of what I talked through today. This is creating a render farm from scratch on Google Cloud platform using you. And down here, in fact, I may actually even have this as a, no, it doesn't really matter. I can just zoom in here, which is all I'd really done before. This is showing kind of a typical deployment for OpenQ on Google Cloud Platform. So you have a bunch of compute engine instances that are running for the rendering hosts. You've got Qbot running on compute engine. A managed Cloud SQL instance running the database, and we have some cloud storage, which is where I said earlier on I was running my startup scripts, but we're using that to actually collect all of the images and media that we're rendering, any videos that we're compiling. And we're storing our Docker images locally within Google Cloud Platform in Container Registry. So that's the other component. So again, I'll include links to our landing page where you can find links to the solution. And that's pretty much it. I will just put this on screen for a second. This is my kind of silly markdown file. So this is the links that I'm going to post up on LinkedIn. But feel free to take a quick pick of that. And with that, I think it's probably a good time to say if anybody has questions, I'll answer and say 5 minutes or so, and that'll be it.